What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to remotely sync AD Connect from another machine. So let's get right into it. All right, so to actually do a AD Connect sync, a lot of people will go into the server that has the AD Connect services already installed, and you will open up PowerShell and run commands to force the sync, or wait 30 minutes for it to go and sync to your tenant. Now, I don't like logging into the server every time to run that command, so I'm going to show you guys how to run it remotely. So right now, I'm actually logged into the machine that has the AD Connect services and application up and running. This is the last time it ran, so I'm going to minimize this, and I'm going to open up this machine right here, because this machine is what I'm going to remotely run the command. Now, the first command that I'm going to run is the following. I'm going to do an enter PS session, and I'm going to enter the name of the server that I'm going to enter into. This is the name, and let's run it. Boom. You'll automatically see within the command prompt that it says the name of the server. This basically means that I am within the server, ready to shoot commands, PowerShell commands, into that server. Now, next command that we need to do is import module. And the module that we need to import would be the AD sync module. So we're gonna run that command. Awesome. Now, every command that you run, you're actually running it within the server, not on your local machine. Now let's hit enter a couple times, and the command that we need to run to actually start the sync would be the following. Start AD sync, sync cycle, and we're going to do a parameter of policy type, and the policy type is going to be Delta, and I like to use a parameter of Rebros. That's it. It's pretty simple. We're going to run this command. Once you run this command, you should get a result of success. Now, if we run into our Active Directory, well, for me, it's my Active Directory because that's where I have the services. You're going to see that it's in progress. It already did the Delta synchronization. It's doing the last export. And that's it. Now, let's go back inside my Windows box. And the last command that we need to do is we need to exit out of the PS session, the PowerShell session. That's very important. So this is the command that we need to type in, and then we're going to run it to exit out. Make sure that you exit out of your PowerShell session, because if not, every time you run a command, you're going to be inside that server and you don't want to do that. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.